Problem child. Alright, y'all. Today, I'm gonna put this little boat anchor thing on it, so I can kind of easily, you know, drop the anchor when I want. I'm gonna also install some homemade rod holders made out of PVC. Kind of do like a spider rig, basically. And I picked these up from Lowe's. Basically like a plate stand, and I can just put the PVC in. You'll see, it's gonna be like a T-bar. You'll get the concept. We're gonna see how this turned out though. Yeah, y'all stay tuned. All right, y'all. I already pre-drilled some holes in here. Exactly. I mean, you can pick this damn thing up at Walmart for like a couple of dollars. So the same pattern of holes right here, right there. So literally all it does is go right on top of it. There you go. Just line the holes up. Put these machine screws in, self-driving screws, I believe. And then that'll be it for that. Alright guys, so the next thing I'm going to be installing on this little boat is this stand, and as I proceed, you'll start to get the idea, the concept of what I'm going for. You know what, I might put that bit right there. Come on. I didn't think about it. See, originally I was going to put it right here, but I feel like the plastic is going to be probably too thin, so I think what I'm gonna do is put that right there. Yeah, man, yeah. Alright, I think we're getting something, so. Probably put about right there. You figure when I'm in the boat, probably gonna be about right about there. Controlling the trolling motor. Yeah, so if my hand can hurry up and get to it. Alright, so yeah. You know what? I think I'm gonna put it right there. Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna line that junk up. Probably be about right about there. Alright, that's the next task, y'all. Stay with me. Alright y'all, now I'm about to basically do some pilot holes so I can screw this to lock these, to lock this damn plate in basically. So I'm gonna see how this shit goes. You know, I should probably mark this, but I don't feel like it. We're gonna eyeball it. No one's different than shit. Probably gonna put about right there. Oh my god. Y'all don't laugh at me. I know what I'm doing. It's just something that sometimes don't work. I ain't sure though. Y'all don't know, man. That's the big boy right here. I got it tarped up right now. I ain't about to bring it out. I gotta find a good spot to fish before I bring that back out again, because I ain't been having no good luck. But that's the big boy.
And y'all, all I'm doing, basically the cheap man way. Unless you want to go out there and buy, you know, pay $100 or whatever, how much they cost for them spider rig fishing holders. You can do that if you want, if you got it. I mean, hell, I could too, but me being frugal, I just like to do shit on my own like that, so. I don't know, I just get a little bit more accomplishment out of it. You know? Just makes it even better when you catch fish off of something that you created on your own. And guys, this ain't nothing but a little Bass Pro Shop. Actually, I think I got this one from Field and Stream, the website, but same damn thing as a pond bass prowler, whatever. It's an 8-footer. Can fit 2 people comfortably, no problem. It's usually just me on there fishing, so I got all the space that I need. You feel me? And as tight as it can go. Yeah, that shit ain't going nowhere.
Alright. So as y'all can see, I got them both in real tight. Boom, boom. So the next step is to take this PVC and start the process of building that spider rig. So as you can see, it just goes in, and what you have to have is a little hex key. You just tighten it in. That's it. This is a good way to make like selfie sticks or whatever on your boat, or if you need, you know what I'm saying, whatever basically. But today's purpose is to build a spider rig, crappie rod holder kind of thing set up. So y'all stay tuned.
Hey y'all.
So the next step I did was basically, I got 2 13-inch pieces of PVC that I cut in half, not in half, but cut with this little tool right here. I don't forgot what it's called, but jigsaw, should have known that. Not much to it. You can use some PVC cutter, but it's just, I'm using the tools that I got at my house, so. So again, the next step, once we have our 2 pieces, I already got one in there, just so you can see. I mean, basically, it's gonna go right in there. And the other one goes right in there. As you can see, it's also gonna require, again, that hex tool that I was talking about. Whatever it's called, wrench. And you just basically, this is how I'm gonna secure the rod, I mean, the PVC to this little unit. Just tighten it up, it screws like a little into the actual PVC. So that's what I'm gonna do to tighten it up. Boom. That wire. And that's how this is not gonna be going nowhere. You know?
So just like that. So about halfway done. Next step is to get the T-bar, which I actually left, so I gotta run to the store real quick. So I'll be right back, y'all.
I'm sipping tea, be what I eat, get that feet, no sense green, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee, good reflexes like you knock the knee, SS feet, do I delete, my boots from Greece made with feathers from geese, counting loosely with the face of the sea, get up, spread, count to you.
It's on my nemesis, rifle, if you pull up then you dead on rifle, we gon' cross him like a symbol on rifle, close fucking up cause he moving like without a spinal, leppin' out, won't bike, land pineal, on the patio, fucking Princess Peach Mario, yellow Louis V overalls on me look like Wario, on the mic I'm an animal, cardio to audio.
I'm in the land of the lost, and I'm still Jack Frost. I'm a conscious, a Constantine, a hot sauce, Jack skeleton limbs, cause I'm known to pop off. And I'm on with the force, so the same as my song. Got a stick tucked in like RuPaul. 2 bananas on a boat in a U-Haul. And the dope looks sick like Wuhan. Another brick coming in for Tucson.
Now I'm back from the store. So, now that I get all the tools, this is exactly what I was looking for. It's basically like a T-bar shape adapter basically. So now that way it's gonna fit right on top of there.
Boom. Straight like that. Turn it. Turn it if I please, whatever. Same thing over here. And the goal is to have these inserted. Like that. Now that one inserted. So it starts to look like that. Like a big T. Same thing over here. Just to kind of give you an idea temporarily anyway. So that's the concept. So y'all see where I'm going. So the next step, I got about four of these little cheap fishing rod holders from Walmart. So the next step, what I'm gonna do is basically install it right here. All right, real simple, real easy. So that way I'll still be able to swivel it, adjust it up and down at an angle, whatever. So I'm gonna have one right here, one right there, one right here, and one right there. So I'm gonna have a total of four rod holders for this little spider rig that I'm creating. And guys, all this is literally like, oh man, I know it's less than 30 bucks. You know what I'm saying? So if you want to go out there and spend $100 plus or whatever, be my guest. Go ahead if you got it. But if you're trying to save a little bit in the times that we're in, go ahead. Take this as a little beginning step. I'm not saying my way is the best way, but it's the way that I configure. All right,
guys. So as y'all can see, that's what the finished product, well, before I paint it anyway, it's gonna look like. So it's got the rod holders, two of them that's adjustable. So all I did is took the packet apart, ran from the bottom the bolt. And I'm able to use this so I can still tilt it up and down. Now with the T-bar though, I did have to screw the T-bar in with these two screws. You can use glue if you want, whatever, but I just went with the screws. But real simple, real easy. Homemade, do-it-yourself, crappy rod holder. Simple. So next one, I'm going to do that one. Y'all stay tuned. What's up YouTube? Appreciate y'all for tuning in. I finally was able to get a day off and decided to take the little 8-foot pond prowler out to the little local pond. It's not the one in my neighborhood, but one towards the city in Savannah. But all I'm doing really is just doing a little spider rigging. And just to show y'all the do-it-yourself spider rig configuration that I did, I mean, real simple, real easy. But yeah guys, just slowly trolling just to see if I can, you know, entice something. Every now and then I'll rock the boat a little bit just to kind of give it some movement. But using about, I want to say about three different colors of jigs on these, and then I also got a live minnow on that one just to see, you know, what they want today. I'm fishing right at about like six feet maybe. See if that's gonna trigger anything.